I'm Steve Ross. I live in Florence, 59, and I'm going to set this up as the way it was. I work on an Aerojet General property way south on almost to the Everglades National Park. They made solid rocket fuel. They got involved in fish farm with General Tire, which was part of major company. So I worked out there on the fish farm. This is way out in nowhere land. And about 1975, I came in to work one the morning, and some friends of mine were already there. One guy lived there, tech place. And we made an offering of fruit, mangoes, avocados, and stuff, just to see what kind of footprints would show up. We're thinking raccoons, and maybe a deer, and maybe something like that. Went out that morning and found these big footprints. There were 75 of them. So as investigating even further, there were some with just the ball of the foot and the mud squished up between the toes. Some partial prints, some actually side by side. We took casts of those, which I brought with me today and showed around. And there was a little plot of sugar cane that we had planted just for our own consumption and fun. It was all tore up, and one of them was pulled out, and there was a big bite taken out of it. The mouth about twice as width of mine. Also, under this shed, we had 20 foot long by 4 foot wide by 4 foot deep tanks that we had catfish in. And one of these tanks was pushed off of about 2.5, 3 feet off of where it was originally put. My friend Alan, who lived there, heard that noise in the night and didn't know what it was. Until the next morning when he saw that. I had friends that had seen this thing cross the road, two people who worked on the property, and that's about all I have, except that I believe it's real animals out there that we just can't seem to find often enough. Thanks.